Street Ride 1987's garage. As you can see, we're working on a 1987 Suzuki Samurai, one of the rare little beasts. We took the windows out, put panels in there where the windows were, as you can see, back door too. We took the bumper off where the taillights used to be, and we used Grand-Am third stoplights for the taillights. Of course, we recessed those and the lights are on the inside. Up underneath here, we've got a 373 S10 rear. Of course, we had to modify that and we shortened it up, narrowed it up, and pushed it up so we could get the thing a little bit lower. And forgive us for the little temporary fuel cell there. We all have our little temporary fuel cells, you know, like coffee cans and stuff like that. But anyway, that's what we're using just to demonstrate what we've done here. And if we look over here, here's the hood for that little beast. That's all sheet metal. We made that scoop there, and that's all sheet metal, and all welded on and bondoed in. And we're getting ready to paint that. And let's take a look up here at the motor. There's our motor. That's a 3.8 Buick V6. We've got a 390 Holley carburetor on it. It's got a Holley intake. We put some chrome valve covers on it. Chrome air cleaner. Motor's dirty. We haven't painted the motor yet. We're just trying to get it running right. Get all the bugs worked out of it, and then we're going to yank that baby out of there and paint it up and put it back in. And we fabricated some headers down here. We couldn't find any headers that would fit, but we're kind of close down here, as you can see. We had to fabricate these headers from scratch. Went to the junkyard, and we happened to find a radiator there that fit in there perfect. Came out of a Chevy Monza, which you don't see anymore, but the radiator was perfect, and it was a new one. Couldn't believe that. It still had the tags on it. And here's our grill we fabricated. That's the stock Suzuki grill. It used to have round headlights in it. Cut the bezels out, put four headlights in there. They came out of a Geo Storm, and a little park and signal lights there. They're motorcycle lights. So we fabricated a grill there to where they fit in there and made some brackets to go in behind it. Up underneath here, we've got a fabricated 4-inch drop axle, straight axle. We took the stock pan off. That was, the well was in the middle. We moved the well to the back so it would go over the axle. And anyway, we got a little mild cam in there, and that's about all we've done to the motor. Mild cam and carburetor and intake. And we made our exhaust. That's not complete yet, but we made some chamber exhaust. There's some pipe and put some baffles up in there, as you can see. We just got them hanging in right now. They're not welded up. We haven't decided whether we're going to bring them out the side or go straight back with them. But anyway, we'll get to that pretty soon, too. And we just stuck these old racing wheels on here, and just to have something to roll it around. You know how that goes. But anyway, that's about it for the little project here. We'll take a look at the inside here before we go. We got the steering wheel out of an S10 pickup. We made the dash. I think I'm going to do that in black. And we put our tack up here on where the clock used to be. Just used the clock open and made a bracket for it. Down here we put all our gauges, made our nice little sheet metal console, took the top off of a console that we found, and made need the rest of the console. You can see the cutouts there for the seats when you move them up and down since it's so tight in here. Cut the floor out and made us a nice little hump there for the transmission. Moved the pedals over. We got us a roll cage in here that we haven't finished putting the bars in yet. We want to get everything done in the floor before we put the sidebars on so we don't have to climb over. But anyway, that's our little project for now. And we'll get back with you later on. Hope you enjoyed our little clip here. Have a good day. Bye-bye.